Here in Waitangirua and Porirua, more state houses are being made available for locals.
Yeah, it's really warm in here, right?
Yeah, it's a nice place. I was in here a couple of weeks ago, as I say. It was a little bit different.
Yeah.
So it's nice to have people moving in here, but I think you probably get the feel that it's built well, good quality, good heating.
It's new developments like these that has Faafoi enthusiastic about his new role, an associate minister in charge of public housing.
Did the promotion come as a surprise?
You never really take for granted that it's happening until you hear the words leave the Prime Minister's mouth. So to get that phone call from her was a huge privilege and exciting. And now to have the responsibility around public housing and homelessness is also a huge privilege for me. I grew up in a state house, and I think that was one of the fundamental things that I had growing up, which allowed my family to give me the opportunities that I've got now. So it's my job now to make sure that we can max out the opportunities for families similar to mine. Pacific families, Māori families, all those families who find themselves in difficult positions with affordable housing and good quality housing.
It's a task he's not taking lightly, following the controversy and progress on the government's flagship policy, Kiwi Build, what was intended to curb the country's housing and affordability crisis. The recent reshuffle with Megan Woods replacing Phil Twyford as housing minister, a signal the policy may not be fit for purpose.
Look, there's a crisis. I think we're trying to do a lot of things in the space, and I think, importantly, I think we're also going to have to ask people for patience. I think there's a housing affordability in the first home buyer space with Pacific people too. So making sure that their aspirations are met in terms of owning a house, we know that there have been mistakes made, and that's why the changes have been made, and we want to get that program up and running and with some momentum, as well as public housing. So we don't shy away from the challenge.
It's only been a week since Faafoi took up the role. It's worth noting he is still yet to receive a briefing package, but the Prime Minister sees him as a safe pair of hands, and he already has his priorities for public housing.
Making sure that you can deepen some of the partnerships that we've got, especially with community housing providers, I think is going to be pretty crucial. I think also kind of getting into some of the weeds of what's going on within the public service to make sure we can make things happen as soon as possible. The problem is huge, realising we can't turn around 9 years of neglect in 3 years, but I think we can make a bloody good go of it, and because every person that has some family members staying with them is also feeling the effects of overcrowding in homes. I think Pacific families are 10 times more likely to be homeless, are 40 times more likely to live in overcrowded conditions, so I'll work to make sure we can reduce that as much as possible.
But time is not on his side. Faafoi has just 18 months to make an impact before the next elections, with the future of his government potentially relying on the success of the housing portfolio.
It's a big problem, not of our making, but certainly we've got the responsibility to sort it out, because I understand personally what difference having a good, solid home can make to a family, what being part of a community means to a family, what having a good education and being healthy means to a family as well. And if I think about the reasons why I contemplated making the mad decision of being an MP, it is to make sure that I think that the families who are in my situation when I was young get the same opportunities. So I'm here now, I've got that responsibility, it is big, and I want to deliver.